These are the primal parts we made in the last episode. In here I have the metal parts that will become a Lego to put together with these. For the no compromise wire foam drops. Whoa! This is a goodie bag. This is for later. Today we're gonna have fun with this Lego kit. I just discovered a mistake in the plywood piece. All these holes should have been drilled out by the CNC machine. I just forgot them in the toolpath probably. And I'm going to use this metal piece as a guide to get them accurately placed on the drill press. I'm so happy I made this into a CNC operation, because that is perfectly aligned. Here's what the marble shuttles do. When the shuttles is in this position, you can see that there's wood here. The marble cannot go anywhere here. In this position, it's open to fall through. You can see my finger through the hole. So let's start here. Marble in the marble shuttle. It disappears when the shuttle is moved this way over this opening. But it hasn't fallen down into the bucket yet because it's catched by the L hook underneath. So not until I return, you will hear the marble falling down into the bucket. So when the shuttle drops the marble, the L-hook catches it. When we go back, right now these marbles can't go into the marble shuttle because there's already one marble in there. I move forward. This cue cannot move, because it's meeting wood in the marble shuttle that I just demonstrated. The marble that was here is in the L hook. When I go back, the queue jumps one marble as the first marble of this queue goes into the marble shuttle. Each marble are resting on four positions, in the PMMA pipe here, in the shuttle there, in the L-hook under here, and on the release arm that we don't have for the moment right here. And all these four positions are strictly necessary for the Marmachine X to work. I don't know a simpler solution, this is not overkill, this is just what it has to do for me to be able to control the feeding and releasing of the marbles correctly. Only simpler version would be MIDI keyboard. See, the marble is not supposed to be able to stick there. It's just some plywood fiber I'm gonna remove. Okay, so, moment of truth, docking 100 washers at the same time. Oh wow. Okay, one pile down. Whew. So the dry fit of the mechanism is done, it works perfect. And I'm gonna remove the bottom plate so we can start with the marble releases. Before I start with the drops, I need to prepare a test scale. I've chosen a scale and I need to do the latex now. This is 1 milliliter, thick enough to be self-leveling. So this is everything I cut off from the machine with the angle grinder. Now I'm going to recycle these 5 millimeter rods again for the marble drops. The marbles are released here, parallel, but they should hit the middle of the plate here. So we need the marble trajection to curve into the same spot. The accuracy is crazy. If you see there's a little blue paint gone there, it's because I marked it with the blue and the next marble is just hitting exactly the same spot. So I can test the drops. So the marbles are hitting a little bit too much left. Then I can just go in here. Good. This assembly, it's the best thing I ever built. Wow. I knew there was going to be interference risk here. So there's only like 5 mm interference, which makes me believe that I can just sand that off here and I don't have to rebuild the last channel or move these pipes. Haha. Nice. I made a mistake. Maybe it wasn't even a mistake, maybe I'm just learning. And the latest philosophical fad is stoicism, isn't it? And a stoic would say that any setback is a chance for an exciting adventure to find the best workaround. So let's go on a stoic adventure together. So you can see this from the front, it looks great. I welded the first front in the row. I checked the distortion of the metal and it was no problem. And then I welded the front row. And what happens with the metal when you weld it is that it heats up and it expands and then it starts to shrink in. So this front row started to shrink in, making this piece a banana shape like this. And then I started to weld a lot on this side just to heat it up and have the piece distort its way back, which it did, but I welded too much, which it distorted way and became like that. And then I went down here again. And then I overcompensated again, and then I was like, wait, every time it distorts itself like this, it should start to shrink into the middle. And that's exactly what has happened. Over here it has shifted like 2 mm, and over here like 2 mm inwards. I have to try to save this piece somehow. So I think I'm going to cut it off here and here, put the middle piece on, and then the outside pieces, and then spread them out. And then weld them together again. Setbacks, setbacks. No, it's not a setback, it's a stoic adventure. We can position one of the loose parts. And here comes the interesting thing. Okay, this will work. Welding hot to not burn the plywood more than necessary. That looks straight. This little corner was obstructing the movement of the 22nd marble shuttle. No more. Final assembly. Let me show you why I think this is one of the best things I've ever made. Because it's the correct solution to a really complicated problem. And look at this. If the first channel loads from here, it's now the marble is in here, and then it activates, the marble is now on the L hook, nothing else happens. And when I push it back, this marble is released to the arm and the cue is charging. So to make this play, I have to connect the marble shuttles to all these arms here, and the marble feeds up to here to the marble divider with the PMMA pipes. Unfortunately, I have to wait with showing that until next video, because I've been racing to get this in place for this video since the metal parts arrived. And I'm absolutely exhausted, but I'm so thrilled. This will look great when you have all the arms in front of here. It will not be as much of a plywood block in the middle of your eye. If you believe in this solution, you can put playing live on this video. Seriously, this is a more mature design than almost anything else I've done on the machine. The solution is correct, the execution is correct. Only hiccup was a TIG welding distortion, but that was a very teachable moment for us all, so that was good, we went through that. I want to thank everyone who is funding this crazy project through YouTube memberships and Patreon. Every week there's a lot of new backers joining. I want to say welcome to everyone, and I want to say thanks to you for watching and following this crazy build. This is the best thing I ever built. I feel I'm matured as a designer. The tolerances are there. The execution is there. It's the correct solution for the problem. It does exactly what it's supposed to do. And that's it. Have a wonderful day, everyone, and take care. Ciao.